Hey, Faithbox family, Ricky here, and I wanted to take a second to share a hope-filled message with you. Many of you may know this, but my wife, Chris, and I are, while we work for Faithbox, or I work for Faithbox, our primary focus and calling is to pastor the church that God has called us to here in New York City. And so what I want to do is kind of for a moment, maybe switch over to my pastoral hat and share just a hope-filled message during these kind of crazy, ever-evolving, rapidly changing times. And, you know, before I jump into it, I would encourage you, if this is helpful to you, if you found it to be hopeful, then feel free to share it, email it to someone, share it on your social media, and let people know, because I think now more than ever, we can all benefit and use a little bit more hope in our lives. So I want to share a scripture that I think is very familiar to a lot of people. And the scripture is found in the book of Philippians, chapter 4, verse 13. And it was written by the Apostle Paul to the church at Philippi. And the verse says this: "For I can do everything through Christ who gives me strength." Other translations might read this or might read, you know, "I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me." And this is a very familiar verse. It's a verse that many of us have used and held on to in different times of our lives. Maybe you're holding on to it during this time of your life. And this verse is really powerful. It's really significant, and it shares a lot of hope and encouragement. And I don't want to, but the thing is, I don't want to share as much about the verse as much as I do about the story behind the verse, because I think the story behind the verse is actually very applicable and relevant to the times that we're in as we're facing and navigating this COVID-19 pandemic. And if you want to read it for yourself, you can actually find the story in Acts chapter 16. And in Acts chapter 16, the Apostle Paul, I'll just paraphrase it for you. The Apostle Paul is doing his business, you know, starting churches, sharing the gospel across the Mediterranean. And he feels like he's supposed to go to this region in Asia to share the gospel and start churches there. But as he's preparing to go, the Holy Spirit actually prohibits him from moving in that direction. So then he thought to himself, okay, well, maybe I'll go to the north to a region called Bithynia. And as he's getting ready to embark on that journey, again, the Holy Spirit forbids him from going to that region. Well, then eventually Paul has this vision where he believes the Holy Spirit is leading him to the region of Macedonia. And so he sets off for this journey, arrives to Macedonia, to this town or this city called Philippi. And in Philippi, he would meet several prominent people, several influential people, and he would lead them to Christ. Their families would get saved. Other people would start coming to Christ. And he would start this young, kind of fresh church in the city of Philippi. Eventually, he would leave Philippi, and then he would write them a letter that we now know as the letter to the church or to the Philippians. And in that letter, we find this verse, Philippians 4:13, "I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength." And it's a pretty significant thing. But I think one of the things that stands out to me is that from Paul's experience, there's some things that we can take to experience hope, to find joy, and to have peace during these times that are changing and evolving as we go forward day by day by day. And so I just want to share three quick thoughts with you to encourage you as you go about your day today. The first thought is this, around change. Change. During this time, everything has changed. Our lives have been completely upended. The way we work, the way we parent, the way we educate, the way we shop, the way we connect, the way we experience our Christian community and fellowship, all of that has changed. Now, change for a lot of people can be a scary thing because we're creatures of comfort, we're creatures of habit, we're creatures of convenience, so we like things that are stable and secure, and change seems to pose a threat against all of those things. And yet, when I think about Paul's example here, he had plans. He had intentions to go to certain parts of the world, and the Holy Spirit said, "Hey, not right now. I'm changing that. I'm sending you in a different direction." And I think one of the things that we can take from that is that change doesn't need to be scary. Change is really God's way of saying, "Hey, it's not this way. I'm moving you in a different direction." And yes, while education and work and family and social times have all kind of changed, I think the change that I want to encourage you to consider is the change that's happening within. What is it that God wants to lead you toward that says, "Hey, I want to build something new or something different. I want to kind of set you on a different direction in your relationship with me." Maybe the way we pray, the way we read the Bible, the way we connect with God, the way we hear God's voice, the way we worship. God wants to lead us on a way or a path of change that's actually going to be more fruitful and more beneficial for our relationship with Him. The second thought I want to share with you is about connection. Connection. Of course, it's kind of crazy when you look at this story and when you consider the implications and the connections that have taken place because of what Paul did. You know, he adapted to change, he goes to Philippi, he meets some people, there they become to follow Jesus, or they begin to follow Jesus. He starts a church, he writes a letter, and then 2,000 years later, people like you and I are finding hope and encouragement, and we feel like we're connected to Paul and connected to his experiences and connected to that community at Philippi because the message resonates within our lives. And I think one of the things that's become completely apparent during this pandemic is how connected the entire world is. You know, 5 months ago, we didn't even know about COVID-19 or coronavirus. Yet, because one person became infected, now the entire world is being impacted. And while that connection might seem like a dangerous thing, I think we ought to flip that on its head and consider the positives of how connected we are. You see, God created us both for connection and to be connected. And when we leverage that connection, when we see that, hey, I'm connected to you, I may not know you personally or face to face, but I can still be connected to you. Now more than ever, we need to remain connected to one another, to share hope, to share encouragement, to share joy, to celebrate, and to bring light into dark times. But our connection is the vehicle and the means through which we can do that. So the third thing I want to share with you is this. We have change, there's connection, and then there's commitment. Commitment. You know, Paul's journey to Macedonia was not easy. And his experience in Philippi was not simple or straightforward. In fact, in Philippi, he found quite a bit of challenges. He was falsely accused. He was imprisoned wrongly, unjustly. He didn't have a fair trial. He was beat. He was attacked. And so it would have been easy for Paul to maybe just quit and say, you know what? It's not worth it. But instead, because he remained committed to God's mission and God's calling on his life, he was able to see a church grow and be planted and grow, and then to pour into them and to write encouraging letters to them. And then we today are benefiting from that some 2,000 years later. And while we don't know how long this coronavirus pandemic is going to last, we don't know how long these changes are going to be in effect. What I do know is that if we remain committed first and foremost to the Lord, if we remain committed to God, and then we remain committed to one another, we can get through this. And not only can we get through it, but we can come out of this stronger, better, and more impactful than we were before we went into this. But it's going to require our commitment. Like I said, our commitment to God and our commitment to each other. But here's what's exciting about that. Can you imagine that just like Paul, because we adapted to change, because we chose to leverage the connections that exist, and because we remain committed to the purposes and the calling that God has placed on each of our lives, can you imagine who is going to be impacted 2,000 years from now? And you say, well, Ricky, that's impossible. I'm just a regular person. But that's the best part. God has always been in the business of using regular people like you and like me to make an impact, to spread or to advance his kingdom, and to share his goodness with the entire world. So Faithbox, I just want to encourage you. I hope this message helps you. I hope it gives you hope. And I hope that if you find it helpful, you will share with other people because we're in this together. So let's adapt to change. Let's embrace the change. Let's remain connected and let's stay committed to the calling and the purposes that God has called us to in each of our lives.